Our bed situation has definitely escalated lately. Riley and Parker are escaping their cribs most every night now, and they're waking up and terrorizing Hazel in the middle of the night. Danielle's wanting to just delay this whole process of them getting big girl beds, and I don't get why.
This is exactly what I'm talking about, Adam. Ava. We put the other three in big girl beds, we're losing more control.
I mean, really, I think that Danielle just doesn't like the stress of having to make the change. I know Hazel wants a big girl bed.
No.
Yeah, well.
See?
Don't swing Hazel on the other side.
I really want to make this an easy transition on her. So while Danielle's out of town, my idea is to get the rest of the big girl beds. If we just get that first night over with, then once she gets back home, it'll just be smooth sailing after that.
Daddy, watch out.
Okay. Go, Hazel, go!
Whoa, yeah! Hazel!
Yeah! Go to town, Hazel. Whoa!
I guess it's cold.
Hey. Almost done?
I think so.
Is there anything I need to know before you skip down?
I'm leaving for a work conference today, and I'm kind of excited as a mom of six kids to kind of just get away, even if it's work-related. But you still miss your kids. I already know, like, I'm just gonna constantly be checking in on my phone. Like, I just know it.
Hey, look who's here.
Oh. Are those the beds and big ass boxes out there?
Yeah, that's the beds.
I don't know how we're gonna do this with eight kids in the house.
Well, we'll try. The project for the day is to build big girl beds for Riley, Parker, and Hazel. But first, I'm supposed to be getting the girls out for their daily outing. Let's go.
Where are we going?
Come on, girls. Let's go inside. We're gonna go inside. You wanna go see some animals?
Let's go see the baby. Let's see the animals.
I was gonna take the kids to the zoo for a little bit, but I needed to take them somewhere a little bit more contained. So I thought of the next best thing.
Where's the blue fish?
Right here.
Where's the yellow fish?
Right there.
That's the yellow one?
Look at you! Okay, now the thing about these guys is they're very, very pokey, okay? So we don't want to touch their, or you can, that's okay. What about a hissing cockroach?
A hissing cockroach?
A hissing cockroach.
I grew up in a trailer. I've seen it all the time.
Hazel, you want to touch it?
No.
No. Look at you.
Okay, she's so brave.
No.
I cannot believe that Hazel pet a cockroach. I think she's secretly the bravest Quint.
Do you see the bunny? Yeah.
He's
very soft.
I think the bunny is an instant hit with all the kids.
Daddy, please come and buy it.
Especially Blake.
Daddy, please.
You think you can be responsible and feed it? And clean up after it. That means even picking up poo-poo like that right there off the ground.
Yes.
Oh. Dude, are we seriously gonna leave here with a bunny?
I don't know yet.
I didn't think that was the plan.
It wasn't the plan.
Danielle's on board with even getting one?
Daddy.
Oh. I mean, we've really been trying to give Blake more responsibility, so I think getting a pet could be a really good idea. All right, I guess we're getting a bunny.
All right.
All right, we gotta get one from the back. That's just a display.
Yeah, you can't have that one then. When Danielle sees that bunny, she's gonna flip. But hey, at least it's not a dog.
Hey, if we're buying the bunny, this is the rest of our day, right? We're not.
No, that's why I called Taylor. She's gonna be at the house when we get home. She'll help the girls stay occupied and we'll knock these beds out.
I guess.
If these girls are gonna sleep in their beds tonight, then me and Dale have got to hustle.
Oh, this is perfect. That rabbit's gonna jump over this cage.
Luckily, Bun Bun Fuzzy Busby should keep the girls all entertained while we work.
Okay, this one's done. Dude, what a pain in the butt.
I know, these are difficult.
I don't even know if I wanna be heard to know that I'm a part of this.
I mean, I think she's initially gonna probably be a little aggravated. This is something that we needed to do. I just figured this way, Danielle will not have to deal with that adjustment period.
I'm kind of curious to see how they're gonna do.
I just hope that she appreciates not having to make the change over the big girl beds.
You might have to rethink Riley and Parker in the same room. They're gonna all end up pulling Hazel's covers off her or something like that. Just jack with her. You know she's my unofficial favorite.
I don't think you have to tell me that.
Okay, girls. You can go see your big girl bed?
Big girl beds. Hazel said, bigger bed.
Bigger bed.
Bigger bed.
No.
You want to go see it?
Y'all go check out. Y'all go check out your new rooms.
The fruit of our labor.
Go check out your new room.
Yeah.
No, that's not Hazel's.
That's mine.
That's mine.
Hazel, that's your baby. Oh, man. Look at that baby. Look at your bed. Look at your bed. Lay down.
You like your bed, Paul? Take my glasses. I'm ready for bed.
Night-night, girls.
Okay, it's time for you girls to go night-night.
No, Parker.
And Hazel.
No, Rara.
And Rara. All three of y'all are going to go night-night.
No.
Yes. No, it's not time to jump, Hazel. Y'all remember the deal. Mommy's away for the weekend, so you got to go easy on Daddy.
No.
Yes, ma'am.
I think that revealing the new beds right before bedtime was probably not the best idea. They are way too excited.
All right, night night.
Oh, man. Dude, look, here goes Riley. look at Riley.
Trying to get
you locked that door, huh?
Yeah, I locked that door. Now she's playing with the cabinet. Come on, Riley, go to bed. What's she doing?
Go back to your bed. Go get in your bed.
And here goes Parker.
Night-night. Night-night, Parker. Lay down.
I have to worry about this all night. Without Danielle here. Dude, this is the best stuff on television I've ever watched, man. It's funny. It's like, seeing you talk to one, the other one pops up.
I may have bit off more than I can chew.
Look at Riley. She's trying to escape.
Oh, I didn't lock the door.
Oh, God.
Lay down.
If they act like this at bedtime tomorrow when Danielle's home, I'm going to be in a lot of trouble.